Now, Google recently confirmed that actually when you put a post on Google My Business, it only remains there for 7 days and then it's removed. So when you think about it, you might think, I've just added a post, and you're thinking the benefits of the keywords, the images, the geolocation, all the things you've done in previous videos, you'll think that that's going to benefit your video. But in 7 days from now, that'll barely exist at all. So I'm going to show you what you can do to make sure that a post continues to benefit your business for far longer than 7 days. Welcome to my video. So I'm Zane from Zanet Design, and I use my 20 years of experience in web designing and SEO to help small businesses like you grow on the internet. So if you haven't done so already, make sure you subscribe down below, click the bell so it notifies you, and then you won't miss out on any of the benefits that come from the next video that I produce. But let's just take this thought for now then. How do we go about then making sure that a post has longer than the 7 days that Google gives it? Well, there's a few ways we can do this. So I'm going to dive in now and show you exactly what you can do to benefit from more than 7 days with your post. So Google's confirmed that when it comes to writing out Google posts, they want various ways in which you can add either events, or you can add different types of posts. So it might be the COVID ones. It could be, in fact, if you look at the posts here, there's offers, there's products, it's another one, events. But as we mentioned, if you just go for the updates, which is what people, the standard process is, one of the things that's been confirmed is that it only lasts for 7 days. Now you might think, well, what does that mean? But in effect, it means that when you put a post, those posts appear in the results of Google Maps, appears on the side. In fact, if you look at various places where you add posts, you'll see that they appear in various areas. So it could be on the maps, it could be on this knowledge panel as well. You often get things appearing here. And these are areas where you need to bear in mind that if it only appears for 7 days, then all the SEO and all the work and the keywords and everything you've done won't really have much of an effect thereafter. So going back to this idea then, what posts will give you more ability to keep a post live and enable it to have a longer benefit than the 7 days? And that's really where events and offers come in, because they have much more of a longer date on them if you know what you're doing. So we're going to look today at how you can add an event. I'm going to add an event that I've got coming up in July. And by adding that, it will enable me to have this showing for much longer period. You notice this, for example, here is an event I posted yesterday about a kickstarting event. And it appears here. And before then as well, I had a post. So posts will appear for 7 days, events can appear basically until they run out. And that's an important part which is brought out here, that when you come to writing posts, just bear in mind that there are various formats they want you to use. So think about the right format. If it's an event, then obviously you have a date and a time. If it's perhaps an offer, then you can produce a coupon. But all of these have, again, it signals to Google that you're using Google My Business in the right way if you produce these things from time to time. Now, going back to here, if you did want a bit more detail on these other things as well and how they're all different, so a lot of people just ignore them, but they are useful, then I have got videos. If you want to know what the special offers are, then there's a video you can find that will help you to see how you can add coupons. And again, that has a date process in it, which is really good from an SEO point of view. And also, if it's just a case of you want to put the right posts, then that's fine. I've got a video that covers that as well. And in effect, what these events do, so if you were to add an event, then Google will pick it up. So particularly if you're an event area, you know, if you're a conference hall, or you're a cinema even, then events and dates do get picked up, and they are presented in a very different way. So as we come out of lockdown, events are going to take on a big part of helping people to know where they can go and what dates they can go. And so that's one of the reasons why I wanted to cover this with you today.
So I'm going to decide to add an event. I'm going to take you through how I do this. So if you click on events, it shows you previous events you've got. So that was one I just put yesterday. But I'm going to add a new event. So click on add event. And again, just to show perhaps a different part of how you can do this, I'm going to add a video. So click on add videos. And in here you have this ability to drop videos in. Now videos, I think, need to be less than 30 seconds. And they also need to be under 100 megabytes. So I'm going to bring in this event that I've got that's on video and just upload that. So the video is being processed. It will take a few moments now for that to appear. But having a video, adding a video as an event, again, that's a great signal to Google. Now working through this then, you might want to add photos instead. That's fine as well. So I need to think about what my event title is. Now, if I go to my event, basically what I'm doing is having like a Kickstarter day for Google My Business. So it is literally a Google My Business Kickstart. So I'm going to add that. When's it from and has it a time? Well, it does. So I'm doing this purely on just one day, which is July the 6th, and it's throughout the day. So if I click on there from 9 o'clock, and it'll be through till 4 o'clock for the last hour, so it's actually till 5. So from 9 till 5 on July the 6th is my event. So I'm going to add that. So 6th of July. It's an all-day event, so it's just on the 6th of July. But it does have times. It's from 9 in the morning and it's till 5 in the afternoon. Add more details. Well, what I do want is I want people to go through and book their time slot on my Google My Business Kickstart. So I need to just add the address. Order online for my event. That takes them through to that. Event details. So I've got my event details here already, so I can just add that and put that there. And what that does now, that just provides all the information needed for one-to-one. I probably just need to put, the fact is it's probably, this will be helpful as well as a description. I'm not sure if it'll be able to take all of that, so let's just do lots of copying and pasting. So we get to preview it. That looks fine to me. Obviously, I've not seen the video, so we'll see how it looks when the video's. So that's going to be for 6th of July. And now that becomes current. And there you go. There's my video. And that's just processing. But now that's ready and current. And it will now be available. So what will happen as the video processes, which will take a few moments, this video now, which as it says, it needs to be 100 megabytes. You can use AVI or MP4 or MOV files. There's a few other various ones there. And obviously, if you want to use photos, then there's some minimum requirements there as well. So this is quite useful to refer to. But what that will do now is that will start to show on my Google My Business website. So you know you have a free business website, which I've got another video that explains how that works. And you'll notice that these things roll off after 7 days if you just do a standard post. And you have to go to view all if you want to then see what the archive was. And all that does is it provides you with this opening up of events here. And then you literally, this is an everlasting scroll. But because this is kind of after 7 days it disappears, that's the only real archive you've now got of the posts that you've done. So let's just close a few of these. But on your actual web page, which is actually getting some kind of Google juice, then 7 days is about it. So this is really important to keep this up to date if you really want to benefit from the SEO benefits of a post. So hopefully that makes some sense. Let's just see how that's getting on. And there you go. So now it's very much there. It's going to be there till 6th of July. And it's very much a case of the video is now playing. You can do you can obviously have it so it opens up. It's under 30 seconds, which is important to do as well. And that's really a great way now of having a video and attracting interest to an event with a good month or two to spare. So that would be my suggestion, is rather than just do a post, why not do a video event with a later date, more than 7 days? And that way you can then certainly bring in more traffic to your event. And at the same time, you've got something that's current for more than 7 days. So on your screen now will appear a couple more videos that I've chosen because I think these will be useful for you and your Google My Business presence.